This is the first time ever that the Tejas production line at HAL is witnessing so much of activities. There is a renewed energy seen all over and better synergy between all the stakeholders. The production rate of initial operational clearance, IOC, fighters has been really ramped up at the LCA Tejas division. Starting from one aircraft in 2015-16, it has been gradually increased to 2 and 5 aircraft in the next 2 production years. During 2018-19 fiscal, we are confident of delivering 8 aircraft. We had our share of issues in the past and all that is now sorted out, said an official. The fighters from SP-12 to SP-16, the remaining from the FOC block are all on the final equipping phase. While SP-12, SP-14 and SP-16 are with the LCA Tejas division, SP-13 and SP-15 are with the second production line at the aircraft division. The SP-12 fighter is ready to undergo a full performance EGR, engine ground run, signaling that it will be ready to kiss the skies for the first time in a week. HAL officials say that SP-13 and SP-15 will be ready for maiden flights in December. The aircraft division will hand over these 2 fighters to the Tejas division after conducting the HSTT, high-speed taxi trials. The last fighter in the IOC series SP-16 will be the first to be integrated with the wings from L&T. We have made all efforts to ramp up the production in phases. Now, we are able to source items in advance. The front fuselage structure of Tejas now takes 53 days to be completed and this used to take 4 to 5 months in the past. Various teams have sat down and brainstormed and we have found many answers, said an official. While the final operational clearance, FOC, announcement is expected next month, the division has already begun advanced stages of production of 10 sets of detail parts. The assembly of 2 sets of airframe have already started for SP-21 and SP-22. The parts for SP-23 and SP-24 will be up by the first week of December. The provisional DUL, drawing applicability list, for FOC fighters were released in October 2017. We have forwarded all the drawings of the FOC aircraft to HAL for production. The drawings were handed over in August and we do not expect any delay. Formally, the FOC should be done by December end, said ADA Director Guy Rish S.D.O.D.A.R. Structural assembly of major modules such as front fuselage, center fuselage and rear fuselage of SP-21 onwards are already under progress, in the structural assembly hangar of LCA Tejas division. Incidentally, the floor assembly of SP-21 front fuselage stage 1 has been provisionally cleared by qualifying authorities, which is a significant milestone towards our FOC missions, added the official. HAL says that the first FOC fighter, SP-21, will fly out by October 2019. It is hopeful of creating a new benchmark by delivering 16 aircraft during 2019-20 fiscal. It is expected that the DUL or the build standard of 8 trainers in the FOC version will now be ready by February 2019, and the first plane will be likely available to IAF by September 2021. The next key task for India's light combat aircraft Tejas is to undertake auto low speed recovery, ALSR, flights. This is part of the last leg of activities towards the FOC, likely to be accorded to the program this December. ALSR is a state-of-the-art feature that guarantees complete carefree maneuvering of the aircraft. In a conventional dogfight situation, the fighter jets need to perform extreme maneuvers. To enable the pilot to concentrate on his combat task, the Tejas fly-by-wire system automatically limits the aircraft parameters to ensure no departure from controlled flight and also ensures that none of the structural limits of the aircraft are exceeded. The IOC version of the Tejas, 16 fighters, already automatically limits many of the aircraft parameters. The only parameter not being limited automatically is low speed, which the pilot needs to monitor in flight. But for the FOC versions, even the speed limiting is made automatic, making the aircraft carefree. Professors and students from IIT Bombay assisted the ADA team to optimize the auto recovery procedures. The advantage of this feature is that it allows the pilot to fly at the limits of the aircraft capabilities by toggling on the low speed warning during combat. However, it weaves around a safety net if the pilot makes any error of judgment. Another related feature in the FOC version of the control laws, which is also being tested simultaneously, is the disorientation recovery function, DRF. Pilots may get disoriented at times while flying into clouds or while flying over the sea. In such situations, a switch, panic button, is provided in the cockpit. The trials for ALSR and disorientation recovery will be done in various air defense and ground attack configurations. The accuracies of the weapon drops have been very good. While the air-to-ground bombs for FOC have been already deployed successfully, there is a need to have a statistical measure of the accuracy of each weapon, which is called as the circular error of probability, CEP. Air-to-air refueling is one of the most difficult exercises for a pilot and is a high-gain piloting task. The FCS came out with flying colors during this tight tracking task, and remarkably the pilot could achieve contact with the refueling drogue in the first attempt. The skills of Tejas were also tested during exercise Gagan Shakti, and it changed the way EAF perceives the program, unofficial said. An official with the FS Sula said the Tejas pilots are now flying to their heart's content, with the number of fighters set to increase in the next few months. At the end of the day, what matters is the availability of flying machines for the squadron. The serviceability has been better and the squadron has been able to train as per their expectations, which is a good sign, Air Marshal Suresh said. We had to physically move the entire range of ground equipment and then set up the maintenance facilities at AFS Sula. We also had to establish the logistics support for spares and consumables to sustain unhindered operations, he adds. The EAF pilots from Flying Daggers are now warming up to ferry out a new fighter from Tejas production line to AFS Sula in 2 weeks after the test pilots complete the mandatory customer acceptance flight, CAF.